Yeah, so first I would like you to start with your introduction, starting with your basic profile, that is your academics and work experience if you have any.
All right. So my name is Praline and I recently graduated from Delhi University back in July and I pursued computer science. It was a BSc course. So it was 3 years long. And talking about academics, in my 10th, I scored 95%. Similarly, in 12th, I had 94.6%. And in my my final CGPA was 8.8. All right. So I joined PwC India as an intern in October. So it is a 6 month internship. And I think, unfortunately, I won't be able to mark it as work experience because what I read, it was before July of 2023. So I'm halfway through my internship experience. And yeah, that's pretty much about it.
That's amazing. So, Praline, what motivated you to pursue MBA?
Definitely, first of all, I really wanted to give CAT a try because I believe it's like a milestone after you graduate college. It's one of those exams that, you know, you should at least try once just for the experience. After that, MBA is something like I pursued a computer science course. But halfway through the course, I realized that sitting in front of the screen and coding all day is not what I want to do. I'd rather move towards the management and, you know, managerial side of tech or tech companies, right? So stuff like project management, product management, and the managerial side really like sparked my interest. And also during my college, I was also part of ISEC, which is an international organization, UN recognized, where I was on a managerial post for 2 years almost. So I had departments on local and national level that I was handling. So it gave me a little input insight into how the managerial side of it works. So I think definitely aligned with whatever I wanted to pursue in the future. And these days, if you don't have a master's degree, it's, you know, you don't have an edge at all. So definitely MBA or master's is something that was the natural next step.
That's amazing, Praline. So did you face any, like, you know, challenges you faced during your CAT preparation?
Definitely, because I was aiming at master's. I decided to join to, you know, prepare for CAT pretty late. People usually prepare for an entire year. I prepared for like 3 months or less than that because I had interviews and all for job and all. So it was a sort of a last minute decision for me. And I decided to join Edu Shastra because it was able to match with my schedule. It was flexible. It was virtual, and it was a smaller group size, which I had preferred. So that way, Edu Shastra helped a lot in understanding how to really attempt and how to go about your strategy for the CAT exam, since it's a very different exam over here. It's all about percentile and how. And even if you should even attempt all the questions. So learning insights from you also, I believe you also took some classes for us and even other teachers. So that was really helpful for me since I started afresh on my MBA journey, did not really have much guidance. But self-preparation was slightly tough because giving mocks and all on my own, I was trying to figure out which would be the best strategy for me. It would obviously, like, everyone, if anyone says that they did not face any challenge in their MBA prep, they would probably either too lucky or probably lying. But I'll be pretty honest, I did face challenges, and I believe I could have done a lot better actually, because in my mocks I was getting a better percentile. I messed up in my verbal section, surprisingly, because that is my strongest suit, and my DILR went really well. Quants was okay as expected. I believe I lagged time management in that section. But if honestly, if I had like 2 more months of preparation, I would have definitely gotten a better score.
But I think within 3 months of preparation, you have a commendable score, Praline. I think that's pretty
good. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, ma'am.
Yeah. So how would you like to define your long-term career goals?
Long-term career goals are definitely completing a master's or an MBA within the next 2 years and getting into a product management in any technical firm. Like currently, even at PwC, I'm in the technical department. So ideally for me, like most of the techies joining Google or Amazon at a managerial position would definitely be on top of the ideal list. So I think that is my, you know, small vision that I have currently. Not sure how things will turn out, but this is my goal for now.
That's amazing, Pallini. So thank you so much for joining in.